Hey everyone, Troy Olson, Skidoo Ambassador. Today we want to walk you through the oil change process on this 900R. It's springtime, it's important that we get the contaminants out of the oil so it doesn't sit all summer. First thing we want to do is we want to get this thing up to operating temperature to make sure we get all of those suspended solids that may be in the motor out of the motor. So we need to take it outside in a well-ventilated area and get it started.
Want to get it up to operating temperature.
Now that we have the engine up to temp, now we can start changing the oil. First thing, let's take the panels off. On this oil change, we don't need to take off the hood, but it makes it a lot easier if we do. So let's get started with taking the hood off. First thing, let's pop off the windshield. Next, we'll go after the two bolts on top here first, which is underneath the gauge. So you wanna grab the glove box door off, pops off nice and easy. Make sure that you watch the cord here for the USB, pops right off. You'll have your first two bolts that you need to take off here on top of the gauge. Now with the bolts removed out of the gauge pod, just pop open the gauge. It comes right out. Grab three of the plugs off the back of the gauge, unlock them, they pop right off. This one on the bottom slides right out. Glove box, one plug. Once you have your gauge and your glove box out, there's just the headlight plugs left to go. So you unplug those. And then you have your wiring harness out of the way. With the gauges removed, this exposes the two torch heads up top here. Remove these two bolts. On the 900R, there are two bolts that you need to take are up here. They're kind of up underneath here a little bit. The ones up front are the ones you need to take out. The ones back here, leave in. The last thing before this hood will pop off here is you need to loosen up the hose clamp on the air intake boot. So grab your Phillips and loosen that. With those six bolt removes, slide the hood slightly forward, pull up, and your hood is off. Now that we have all the panels and the hood disassembled, we need to go underneath and loosen the access panel. There's two Torx heads down here. What I like to do is I like to take one all the way out and only loosen the other, as that way the plate just kind of swings out of the way in there and you don't have to put two bolts back in, and saves you a little time on assembly. The next thing we need to do is remove the two drain plugs on there. Both are easily seen right underneath the access patch. While we let that oil kind of drain out the bottom, the next step is we need to get the oil filter out. So there's a cap right here with three Torx heads on it. We remove those three bolts. With the three bolts removed, you just take the cap and pop it off. This will be the oil ring you need to replace, and pull the oil filter. Once you have the filter out, you can take a rag, or if you have an extraction device, you just get the little bit of oil that's on the bottom of the filter housing and get that all out. Now that all of the old oil with all the contaminants is gone, we have it drained out, we have the old filter out, now let's put this thing back together. So let's go grab our kit. What's included in the kit? You have everything you need to do the complete oil change. The big ones, you have a new O-ring and two new crush gaskets. These are for your two drain plugs, and this is for your oil filter housing cap. You have your new filter, and you have the exact amount of oil, 3.5 quarts of XPS 0W40. Put this back into its oil filter housing, making sure when we tighten this one up that we tighten those three bolts evenly as we go down. That way we get a nice good seal. The other two important pieces, you have the pressure seals or the crush washers that go on your drain plugs. Make sure you replace them, and then you're ready to fill. Grab your 3 quarts of oil out of your kit, put them in, and what I like to do is, once I get the 3 quarts in, turn on the snowmobile, get it up to operating temp, and then use the little half quart one to bring it up to the right level based on checking with the dipstick. If you got the Skidoo kit, for all the oil changes that I've done, it's taken the exact 3.5 quarts that they give you. So this one, we're topped off and it's ready for summer. Now that we're on the assembly phase here, let's get the hood back on. This is the important piece here, is make sure you push these tabs in here, and you want those tabs to lock. I always do a little pull on each side to make sure they got inserted in good. Now with the hood back on, you got your 6 screws, the 2 up here, 2 on the sides and 2 more on the gauge. make sure you get your plugs all back in and your oil change is complete. Again, we really want to make sure we get this oil changed in the spring so that we get all those contaminants and all that stuff out of the machine. So the machine has got nice fresh oil in it while it sits in its summer storage. Hope you find this helpful. Thanks and talk to you soon.